Welcome back to the channel, and today on our Power BI series, we are going to show you how to append your data model to add more rows. Power BI has a couple of features, one called Merge, which allows you to add columns to your model, and then the second version is an Append model where you add rows to your model. And in this example, we're going to continue on with our YouTube channel. We are going to add a couple of additional years to add more data to this model and add more additional rows. Let's go to Power BI. We are back in our Power BI data model, and for those of you new to the series, we have a data table that has two tables. We have a calendar table that has the dates 2020 through May 31st, 2023. And then we have a YouTube data table that has date, minutes, revenue, views, and watch hours. It's a one-to-one relationship between the date column, and the calendar table is identified as the date table. Now, for the append, that is when you add rows to a table. When you want to merge a table, you add columns. So merging makes columns wider, and appending adds more rows, makes tables longer. So currently in our data model, we have 2022 through May 31, 2023 as our data table. The number of rows, when we counted the rows, was 516. And currently our revenue per day is the total revenue calculated by, divided by the number of rows, $16.67. So what we are going to do is append our data table by going to the Power Query Editor by hitting Transform Data. That is going to bring up our model. And in Power Query, we have two queries, the YouTube table data and the calendar table. So what we want to do is add a new source. Now, we've been recently been given 2020 and 2021 data. They're both Excel tables, so we'll import them in one at a time. So we'll bring them into the data model. 2020 is a table identified by this blue ribbon. And so that brings in 2020 into our data model. Then we are going to add another source, which is 2021. And what we're going to be doing is adding more data so that we can start to graph out visually some more trends and try to do a little bit more analysis on this data set. YouTube 2021, again, it has date, views, watch hours, minutes, and revenue. And when you're appending, you must have the same columns in the table that you originally have and the table that you're appending the data to. So now we have 2021, we have 2020, and we have our original YouTube data. So what we're going to do from the home screen, we're going to select YouTube and we are going to append queries. Now this gives you two options. You can append queries or append queries as new. Appending queries as new would make a whole new table. In this example, we're going to append the queries because we currently have the data in our table for 2022 through May 31st of 2023, but we are going to add to this by adding 2020 and 2021. So we're going to append the queries, and we're going to do three or more tables. So the table to append is the YouTube current table, and we are going to add 2020. We are going to add 2021. So currently we have YouTube 2020. We are going to add 2021 all to the current YouTube table. And just by hitting OK, we have done that. Now, to verify that the data has been added, we are going to sort this data in ascending order. And we see January 1 of 2020 as the oldest date. And if we want to ascend it by descending, then we can see 5/31 of 2023 as the latest date. So we know that the data is now in there. So we're going to go back to sorting by ascending. And we still have our same columns, date, views, watch hours, minutes, and revenue. So to apply these changes, we're going to go close and apply. Now watch the revenue per day and the number of rows. We're currently at 1667 and we're at 516 rows. Now we're at $10.86 revenue per day. And the number of rows is at 1,247 because that includes January 1, 2020 through 5/31 of 2023. And remember, the number of rows is the DAX measure of count rows. So when we get to the number of rows, that is calculated as number of rows equals count rows of this YouTube data set. So now, to double check that we have that, we can go to our calendar table and look at the year. And now we see we have 2020, 2021, 2022, and 2023 to work with as a data set. So we're adding more years to analyze. And basically, this table, this YouTube channel started in 2020. That is why the revenue per day went down. And this channel has been slowly growing. Now you saw also our minimum number of views went down. So as early on in this channel's history, the number of views had as few as 21 views in a day. And when you look at the revenue, this YouTube channel on January 1 of 2020 didn't have any revenue. They did have views. And they slowly started to add revenue in, starting with by month, January 1, start of the month, and it started getting monetized on August of 2020. But by adding in this extra data set, we can now start to analyze this channel. So we can do, you know, some visualizations, which we're going to start to do now, adding in those additional years. We've got the additional rows. For the maximum revenue, we can start to chart revenue per day by either per day or see if there's any year over year increases. It allows us to analyze this channel. So when you append, you are adding rows to the data set. And when we go to our YouTube, we see that we have all the way from January 1, 2020. And if we want to sort that by descending, we can see 5/31 of 2023 in our data view. So we'll go back and sort this by ascending. The only other thing we're going to do now is when we go back to the transform data, what we don't want to do, since this data is static, 2020 and 2021, that data will never change. We are going to uncheck the enable load and uncheck. Actually, we are going to not include this into the report refresh. So whenever we do a report refresh now, we won't need to refresh this data because we are going to be using the YouTube channel data table, and YouTube 2020 and 2021 will never change. Now, if somehow somebody updates that data, then we will want to re-add that in and refresh the data. But now we have that, we can hit close and apply. Our data set is set, and we have now added in additional tables, 2020 and 2021. We have appended the data by adding more rows. So that is how you append data in Power BI, and we now have 4 years of data, 2020, 2021, 2022, and 2023. Remember, hit subscribe and watch the video. We showed you a video on how to count rows. We also showed you a video on how to set up your sum, and we've also did a 10-day and a 30-day rolling average for this channel for views and for revenue. So we continue on with our Power BI series. That is how you append data.